Thank you. expressions down upon each other some gag gifts. And these are some things that are kind of special to them. Most of them I think you'll be able to understand after they explain them to you, what they are, the purpose behind them and what they mean. But they're kind of special to us. So presenting them are juniors Valerie Schultz and John Flynn.
Thank you. we got you this little orange juice container, and every time you perform, you can use it.
This next person really means a lot to us, and we decided we were going to do Mr. and Mrs. Anderson this year. And Mrs. Anderson this year has had this thing of trying new things. At the retreat, we played this one game, it's called Cheat the Judge. And we got Mrs. Anderson in a circle, we put all the people around in a circle, and we had someone go in the middle, and you like toss them around the circle until they fall. Well, anyway.
We're very proud of Mr. Anderson for this one adventure that he's going through, and that's beauty school. He has graduation coming up soon. What day is it?
Friday.
So when you graduate, we got these little scissors to cut.
And we made Heidi a mole woman cape.
Due to her back and everything. And she's come back a long way. She did the big show. And we know she was in a lot of pain and it hurt a lot of times. But she never admitted it. She always went through with it. So for you, Kathy, we got you the red badge of courage.
She's shy and everything. And we always think of Teresa as a little girl. Well, she had this feature in the big show that says, I can't say no. Well, Teresa, here's your own can't say no book with all these gorgeous guys. At the beginning of the year, we had this one picnic, and We gave Steve the most important job, I mean, on this whole thing. If we didn't have this, we couldn't eat, and Steve got the bag of charcoal, so we got him this little bag of charcoal to bring to the next picture.
I guess She's also an avid collector of shoes. She has, let's say, like 25 pairs in her house. So Gina, we went out to Kmart and bought a beautiful pair of shoes.
So we got them these two little pictures of each other, so when they go to Wayne Classic, they can remember each
plays. He sits down at the piano and only plays introductions to songs. Like playing an introduction to Old Irish Blessing, and he'll get to where the words are and he'll stop, and he doesn't know anymore. He only knows the introduction to songs. So, we made you, Jack, your famous intro book.
Pigs run.
roasting in the background. Cars lining the front. We gave it our very best. It's something that got us off to a great start. I was very proud of. How about the Beijing Historic Society? We performed, and I wasn't even there. I was in Canada. Unfortunately, my husband had to take them along, but they performed in the middle of the exhibits, moving things around. The audience, those of you parents who were nice enough to accompany us, stood in cedar and in the exhibits to watch us, but thank you for the faithfuls that went along. Sons of Norway, do you remember the two Sunday nights that we went to? Monday said, hey, can you do it again next Sunday night? At first we thought we had a Holiday Inn job. It was just so regular. They liked us a lot.
We should have.
And then came the first show with the band. First one whenever we traveled. The Jazz Hot was my baby this year. That was a song I wanted to do for a long time. Slaved over writing it, lifting it from the record. It took me a long time to write the parts. It took me a long time to write the piano part. It took me a long time to choreograph. Well, not a long time, but it was definite, really concentrated effort. But I didn't write the horn parts. I said, I'll write the horn parts because I thought we'll perform it in April. Well, my husband's killing me, so don't ever do it again. So all of a sudden, we're going with the band, we're going away for a weekend, and I'm sitting there slaving, writing horn parts. So I barely got it for the guys before we were supposed to go. But we did it. We got into a bus, and we were fortunate enough to perform for the Illinois Association of Recreational Beavers. They shipped us out to Oregon, Illinois. We performed at this little Holiday Inn or something. It was very crowded. The band was kind of halfway in the hall. There was a ceiling that was low. Chandeliers we kept eating, but it was also the day after District 7. Most of them had sung for 8 hours. It wasn't our finest hour, but it was a good one. But then we went back to the White Pines Ranch, right? And went into those two dorms room, and we were fortunate enough to have Mr. and Mrs. Brockway go along with us. And, guys, can we tell it? Mr. Brockway snored. What can I say? And it was so funny. We ladies, we were all up there, and we had a great time. And we were all, you know, I mean, even though some of us snored too late, right? But anyway, I come down and I said, you know, because we were two wigs, and I came down and said, well, hey, how'd you guys sleep? And they went, but hey, it was a lot of fun. It was like music ball. And it was the first time I started working on the musicians to really bring them into a part of us, to a part of our unity, to a part of our values. And that's what this has to do with too. We were over a Sunday morning. So as a result we had a devotional service, and it was just kind of friendly. We just kind of talked about values within the group, values as a person, and most all the group went. And this was our candle that we passed around, and we made little wishes for the group and little hopes for each other. So that's why it is represented up here with me as well. December, boy, there's 1 week. We started out at the Hamilton. We were lucky enough to get to sing in the Hamilton Bowls in Prague. We were right in front of the food tables. People had to walk through us to get the chocolate mousse. You remember that? They were walking around with their spatulas. Two people we tracked there. We started doing the opening number, and they were standing there with their plates for the which we'd also performed for the year before for their women's division. This time we got to perform for the men for the entire convention, which was about 2,500 people. It was really fun to get to go in there, you know, ride in like the stars, get to perform. People received us very well, although we had to stand around and wait a long time. And then it was about 11 o'clock at night, and we walk out, and our bus did not work. Remember that? That was also the night that we had to carry Kathy out, because Kathy started her little release, and so for that, the next day we went to the King Home, which is a place in Evanston, which is the neatest home for elderly men. And they come down every day, they dress in ties and sport coats, and we got to have lunch with them that day as well as perform with them. So all the kids were spread around, sharing tables with the gentlemen, and having a nice time and cheering them up as well as performing. On Friday we performed at the First Presbyterian Church. Remember in the chapel they had really good acoustics, like Michael and Johnny came along with us to watch us and help us. And then on the next Sunday was the chorus concert. And And then, 1 week after that was our Christmas show. And Brian joined our staff at that time. Then we come to March 10th, and I'm going to just take a moment to just talk to you a little bit about that, and just reminisce with us very shortly. We practiced hard for a couple of months, and I was very strict with them, I was very strict with the band, I was very strict with everyone. Because as a director, I don't know how many of you know this, but I go out as a guest clinician, I go out and give workshops, I go out and judge places, I go out and do freelance choreographies, doing the kinds of things that I do here. And I have very often given trophies away to first place winning show choirs. And it was nice to be the expert, to be the person up there giving the lecture, to be saying, yes, I scored you, and yes, give positive comments. But I've always wondered what it would be like to be on the other side of the handshake. And that, I guess, was one of the neatest thrills of my life, kids. Because as a professional, I always said, you know, I work hard at home, and then I go out, and people see me for a couple of hours, and they say, oh, she's enthusiastic, I wonder what her group's like. And I always wanted to do and say, wow, you know, the things I work for, the values are really as strong as what I hope they are. We got in a bus on March 9th and we traveled, and everything was fine. And we went there and we saw a couple of groups, and we were a little scared, but we were okay. The next morning we went and saw some more groups. We were okay. We went back to the hotel, and still kind of okay, but kind of quiet. It was really cute, though. We had about 2 hours, and I'd asked, we had two great sets of parents that went along with us, Mr. and Mrs. Brackley and Mr. and Mrs. Drafts. And again, the things that were really important to me are the details, and so all the shoes had to be polished. So okay, we looked like the little Santa's elves, because all the kids, before they went down to lunch, set all the little shoes on Mrs. Brackley and Mrs. Drafts, gave them a little bumping. So that it was that kind of thing. I don't know if the audience or the judges would even notice it, but it was the fact that we knew it. We knew that down to that little detail, that was what was important to us, and that was fun too. And then Jim walked into my room and forgot his music. I committed to it, right, Jim? I said, leave the room. Life, you know, what do you can't make a piece of music appear that's not going to appear. And Jim swears that was the little edge that really helped us all together was that little uncertainty that he didn't have his music along. Whether it was that or whatever. We got all dressed, we were all set to go, and we got in the bus. We're driving on away from the competition. We're about an hour ahead of competition time. And we thought we would sing in the bus. It was dreadful. I panicked. I just went, stop singing, couldn't sing in key, tried to sing Sweet Georgia Brown, which is an acapella number, we should have been able to sing just fine. It was just terrible, I couldn't sing. Okay. So, now we get into there. Aside from the fact that there's all kinds of psychological things going on, because I had judged this competition 2 years ago, these people were really kind of gunning for us. But we were always very positive. Remember how the group from Minnesota came in and there was no one else in the audience that knew it, 35 of us cheered them on. So people really had a good feeling about Buffalo Grove, how they did. How was it that Heidi's... So, we had a great attitude going into it. We were a little scared. People kept walking in to look at us in the warm-up room like, psych out the competition, awesome, you know, check it out. But we just kind of did our thing, right? Okay, so then we got out on stage. We talked a little bit about it. We had a circle before, and we went and said, let's just do it our best. And as I said, we will go make a statement. Whether they like our statement or not, we can't say it. But what we're going to do our very best. And we did. We went out there and performed. We were very well received. And when we got off stage, so many, I mean, in our faces and everything, we didn't care if we'd won because we knew we did our very best. It was so fun to be out there and do that. So we changed our clothes, listened to some groups for about another 3 hours. Our spirits went, we got tired too. Then we went to the place that they were going to announce the winners.
Okay, it was a huge gymnasium. The judges were about half an hour late in coming. We were just lower than low. We were just mellow. Everybody kept saying, oh, you know, you can place it all, we're fine. You know, hey, this is our first time. I remember Sherry being main cheerleader. Now, come on, it's great, you know, it's great. Okay. And so that's how we felt. And then the music came on. Beat it. And Brian Lee's out there doing his breakdancing and flipping across the floor. And it was just super. Everybody just lightened up and suddenly then it broke the tension and it wasn't so tense whenever they came to the announcements. Well, sort of not so tense. So they announced there were six different classes. Class junior high, C, B, A, AA, AAA. We were AAA, the largest schools. So of course they started with the C's and go all the way up to the AAAs. We are still sitting there. I think Mr. Dress, Ron Dress was the only one. He never lost the face. Some of the rest of us just said, hey, it's in someone else's hands. And we'll take whatever happens. So we sat there and listened to the third place winner. And that was one of the groups that we had seen that we were concerned about, one of the local groups. And then the man who had kind of been really trying to psych me out, whose group we had not seen, they received second. And Heidi was already screaming. And I just said, I was sitting next to Jeff and I said, you know, in a couple minutes I may have to walk down there and I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. There's this huge gym, it's all full of people, I'm sitting here with my babies and I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. So then Rich, who was someone I knew, the contest person, said, a group, the first time they've ever performed here at Cook College, my head dropped, Heidi's still screaming. And we all started to cry, and they said, Buffalo Grove, and they all remember we were sitting, because of our jacket through, I was very visible. And so I just kind of dropped my head, squeezed Jeff's hand, and then I went down there. And just to walk down there, and it was okay receiving and shaking their hand and everything, but then looking back at your faces from the floor of the gym, and just seeing them, the smiles. And then we had to perform, okay? Because we received the honor. Not only did we win our class, but we won all classes. We were the highest level compared to any other classes of 56 schools. So we had approximately an hour to get together, put our clothes back on. And we walked over to this gymnasium, sad, it was cold. When we walked back, it was five abreast with expressions in Buffalo Grove jackets, and it wasn't cold at all. We got in those costumes, we had one brush, we couldn't even find it, our hair was just wet. And here, the curtain is all ready to go up, and Mike and Steve don't have their ties on. And they're introducing us, and I'm staring right at them, and I'm going, your ties are ripped.
Thank you.
show. And special thanks to Mrs. Ingram and Mrs. Reed. I know you're up there. There you are. Thank you.
Amy, but her mom, Jermaine.
I did this one. Okay, you can have it.
Thanks, Jeremy. Thank you for the most rewarding, the most fulfilling year of my life. Thank you for believing in me and the things that were important to someone who's my age, coming from someone who's your age. That meant more to me than anything. For you to accept the vision that was in my eyes, and for you to let me take you where I did. What I want to say to you is that the only reason you're sad is because you were so happy. If it hadn't been such a beautiful year, you wouldn't feel so bad about missing it so much. And if you hadn't had so many good times, you wouldn't be feeling the pain that you're feeling right now. So, enjoy. But you are the best thing that's ever happened to Jeff and I. And you have brightened our lives. And I don't want you to think that we have been without our problems, but we faced everything with openness and honesty, and we conquered anything that came to our way, whether it be jealousies amongst ourselves, personality conflicts, men, women, love affairs, whatever. We always dealt with it. We were very honest. We faced up to it as a family does, and we conquered it. And that's what really makes you special. I've had dreams before that have just been fantastic on stage, but I've never had one like you off stage. I've never had one that's been so warm and such a treat to put in all the hours that we do. And I've never had one that appreciated me as much. That limo was a real hit. Because I guess, let's face it, we think we're kind of special in what we take the time to do. And I'm not training musicians the next day, but I'm training young men and women that'll learn to work together, learn to be responsible, and accepting adults. And I am so proud of you. I remember when we got together in the fall, I was, wow, do you think we'll gel together? And I'm just so proud to be your director. Part of you and what you've become. So it's not goodbye. It's not. Remember, Sherry told us. It's not. Things will be different. That's true. But it's not goodbye. The only thing that will change, maybe you won't wear blue fuchsia dresses and black suits. But that's only the outside covering. The bonds that you've created is what's on the inside. And that's not going to change. And that's going to stay there. Thanks to the people that helped to make that all possible. I'd like to present to you Senior Award. Outstanding seniors in this group, as always. And they have given so much to the organization through their leadership, their talents, and everything. I can't thank you all enough for me being able to holler at you or respond and say, okay. Maybe you didn't agree with everything I did, but you always accepted it. And you said, okay, I'll give her a chance. I'll see where it's headed. And hopefully you aren't with okay results. Expressions motives, they selected for themselves the person that they feel is the outstanding expression. And I agree that many, many people could have gotten this award, but this was really well received. And I present it to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.